two ways. It's my favorite holiday of the year, and we celebrate at home with about 75 of our closest friends, have a big pool party, cater Eli's barbecue, and have fireworks, and just have a great time together as a family. And then, obviously, going to Red Rhythm and Boom.
I don't really hang out with either family or friends, and we always watch the fireworks from our house or backyard. Yeah, I'll normally go to a party with my friends and family and watch fireworks and meet a bunch of friends.
We celebrate Independence Day by going to Red Rhythm and Boom. We invite friends. We live close by, so we have friends come park it at our house sometimes, and we walk over.
Usually with a family picnic, going to Red Rhythm and Boom with the family, and seeing neighbors and all the friends there.
As a kid growing up, we would sit upstairs on the third floor and watch the fireworks downtown Cincinnati. We could see it from the windows when we were little kids.
Just lighting off fireworks with my dad and my mom and shooting bottle rockets at my brothers, you know, that kind of thing. You know, the safe things and the barbecues and, you know, picnics and stuff.
When I was really young, we lived out in the country and there was no place to go. And we would sit out in the backyard for hours waiting to see some kind of firework. And I thought it's so weird because now it's so prominent and you've got a whole festival for it, so.
Last year I went with my friends from school and I got to ride the swing and had a lot of fun with them.
I'm from Poland, so Independence Day, it's something new to me. We don't have that in Poland. So just going to see fireworks for the first time with the family, it was very special.
My stepfather was lighting off some fireworks, and Ember went into the box of fireworks. The fireworks started randomly shooting in all directions. And my favorite part of it was my grandmother, who was just sitting in the chair, just clapping and screaming, "Do it again, do it again."
My favorite Independence memory is the birth of my son on 4th of July. That night I watched the fireworks from my hospital room. So that is my favorite Independence memory.
Independence Day is about freedom, fireworks, picnics, peak of summer, having fun and being with family.
It's a celebration of what we do every day, and we are able to have our own business and celebrate our independence, and I think it's very exciting.
I do have family that was in the military. I was in the military myself, so it's just kind of that day to kick back and relax, America style.
Just getting our independence, and we like to teach a little bit about the original meaning here at the preschool, and also it means just another time to get together with the families.
It's just like showing like how grateful we are, like our opportunities that we get. Even just like being at the pool right now, like being able to have this like opportunity and just like, you know, being who we are, getting the chances we get.
Yeah, there's definitely the historical aspect of it, but also I think it's just another opportunity for friends and family to just celebrate the chances that we have to be together.
I'm a former United States Marine, and Independence Day is really what it's all about.
You do all the summery things, and like you stay out late and watch the fireworks, and then you hang out with everyone, and it's just like kind of definitely like personifies summer, I would say.
It's important to celebrate where we came from and you know, the people that fought for us to be here today, for what we've, you know, what this country stands for, so.
Independence is a chance to spend time with the family, a chance to just relax and do, again, the traditional grill outs, barbecues, etc. But it's also a time just to slow down and think about how fortunate we are to live in a country, in a community that allows us the freedoms and opportunities that we have.
As someone who served in the military, Independence Day is an opportunity for me to carry on that tradition of freedom, ability for each of us to reach our maximum potential. Serving this country, this city, this state is an honor and a privilege, and the 4th of July always reminds me of those who came before me.
I like all the activities and where you can come together and be with your fans and family, and like opportunities where you get to volunteer. I like that too.
I like that, like, it brings the community together and you see it when people that, like, you didn't expect.
My favorite part is playing all the games and going on all the blow-ups and eating all the food.
The food. Definitely the food trucks.
Food trucks, yeah. The people.
The people. Letting our kids, you know, just have a good time.
Probably the food trucks and like the games and stuff. I don't know, the food is good there, so.
I love seeing people that I maybe haven't seen in a while.
I think it's a great opportunity for community. And I love that it's free and it's family oriented, but then kind of turns into a party. So I think it's great.
I did know what she just said.
Do they do fireworks there?
Yeah.
I would like to see the fireworks.
Getting candy. Going there with our friends, eating food, eating all the candy, and having fun. Hey, look. Yeah. And jumping on bouncy houses.
Yeah, I like the fireworks.
I love seeing the community come together and see all the people that I know from the community, and obviously enjoy the music. Selling fine alcoholic beverages with the Legion allows me to interact with all of my close friends.
I like the fact that Mason, no matter how big they continue to grow, they still maintain a small town feel. As somebody who went to Mason High School, works in Mason, lives in Mason, it's not uncommon I will go and get a chance to see neighbors, friends, classmates, and I really enjoy that component of it.
I will be definitely going with my daughter and hopefully the rest of my family as well.
I'll probably attend it with my family and maybe bring a couple friends. Same. I'm most likely.
I think I'm gonna go with my friends this year.
I'm probably going to volunteer there with my friends, and then after that we'll enjoy the fireworks together.
My friends and my parents.
Probably whatever friends I can cherry pick to align our schedules and be able to make it, so yeah.
It was last year and it was super exciting. Probably the best event I've ever been to, and I'm looking forward to this year as well.
I think it would be Red Ribbon Boom every year since I've been like five.
I remember it was at Pine Hill when they had the
the first one?
Yeah, one of the early ones.
Oh, I don't remember that one. Yeah.
I think it was 2016, and I just remember going with my parents, and then I met up with some friends.
Long time, when it started first, so I don't remember how many years.
Huey Lewis and the News in 2010, my favorite, hands down.
Oh gosh, there's a number of good ones. We talked about Andy Grammer, that was great. Phillip Phillips holds a special place in my heart because my husband, we love that one particular song, Home. But the most memorable one is definitely Electric Light Orchestra.
I remember they had Andy Grammer one year, and I remember that, but also Phillip Phillips, because that was my first Red Rhythm and Boom I went to.
I've only gone last year, so I saw Smash Mouth. I like that one a lot. Yeah, Smash Mouth was definitely my favorite because I knew a lot of the songs.
I'm going to go with Smash Mouth.
Yeah, Smash Mouth.
Think back to my high school days.
Mine was REO. Show my age.
Yeah, I did like that. I liked Clint Black. I think that was last year.
Yeah.
Two years ago? Okay.
Smash Mouth.
Phillip Phillips. Yeah.
I don't know that I have a favorite performer. What I like about the choices that have been made in the past is rarely is it a band or an artist that I listen to a lot, but as we go to the concerts, I didn't know they started that song. I didn't know they said that song. They're bands that both the adults and the children can all enjoy.
Well, U2, of course, would be my favorite, or AC/DC or Motley Crue, or, you know, any number of 80s rock bands, yeah.
I would love to see country music. I'm kind of partial to it.
I love alternative, kind of upbeat, sort of poppy music. So yeah, just like newer artists that are kind of up and coming.
I love country, so I said Bill Phillips, so maybe someone like him. I mean, like, I'd love to see Morgan Wallen, but that's a little bit of a stretch, probably.
I really like the Fits and the Tantrums. They're pretty cool, so maybe seeing them.
Unfortunately, it'd be really hard to schedule, but I'd like to see Louis Armstrong there. That's my favorite band of all time.
Let's call in some big names. You know, maybe like a Morgan Wallen. That'd be cool.
You can't get Marcus Mumford in here, can you? He's probably a little bit more difficult. Maybe something pop, dance, loud, family-oriented, of course. Something fun.
Willie Nelson is my favorite musician of all time. I love him. And it's going to be hard to get Willie, but Willie Nelson.
I'm going to go Lenny Kravitz.
Ooh, that's good too.
I don't know, somebody big like Def Leppard or something, anything from the 80s, 90s, I'm into it.
I'd say Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton, I don't think that's ever going to happen.
She's pretty amazing.
How about Bruce Springsteen?
Oh, well now, I don't think.
Carrie Underwood.
Anyone ever? Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift.
Maybe Taylor Swift, that's kind of big, but I really enjoy her music.
I love country music. But personally, I can jive to any music. It's fun. There's always a big crowd, and we love the seating.